Hey, if you are a musician like all of us in Central Indiana, or you know a musician, you do not want to miss this exciting conversation. I'm here with Kai McGinnis, the founder of the Indianapolis Music Cooperative, and Richard Sleepy Floyd, a local drummer and IMC team member. Guys, welcome to the show.
Thanks for having us.
How we doing?
Doing well. How are you? Right.
I love it. Just a conversation with fellow artists. Absolutely. Sleepy, I gotta ask, what's the nickname all about, man?
You know, it was given to me as a kid growing up in Kokomo, Indiana. Shout out to Kokomo, all my people back home.
Yeah.
One of my baseball coaches gave it to me just because I just kind of poke around a little bit.
Okay.
And, you know, and then there's a basketball player by the name of Sleepy Floyd. So it just kind of, it was a literal. It took literal meaning.
I love it, man. Just shout out to Kokomo.
Yes,
Kai, tell us a little bit about what the Indianapolis Music Cooperative is and what inspired you to start it.
Yeah, absolutely. So the Indy Music Co-op is an initiative to transform warehouse space in the Circle City Industrial Complex on 10th and Mass Ave into, instead of the traditional hourly studio model or rehearsal where you lock out and the one band has this rehearsal room, but they only use it a few hours a month, right? You're only practicing a couple times. We flip those resources onto a monthly membership, like a music gym.
Okay.
So
That's helpful for me to understand what it is. Like, it's like a music gym.
Sure.
That's awesome, man. So musicians can come in, they can collaborate, they can rehearse, they can record, they can write.
Absolutely.
Sounds like, and it's in a great area of town too. Indianapolis is such a music town too. Not a lot of people will know that, but their history is so rich of music, not just in Indy, but in the state of Indiana.
Absolutely.
And Sleepy, what made you inspired to get involved with the co-op?
Well, because you know, throughout my career, I've been involved on the grassroots level very heavily, you know, whether it be booking or just networking and putting bands together or just, you know, consulting for other bands. So I felt like I've already been doing the work, and I saw an opportunity for us to just amplify that and magnify it and just make it a community-wide initiative. And knowing that there are barriers to a successful music career coming from Indianapolis,
right.
We need to be, we want to be a catalyst for, you know, providing greater opportunities for the music community.
Man, that's awesome. I love it when artists can connect and kind of things happen organically where it's like, oh man, you're into that kind of music? I'm working on this. And ideas get formed that way. It sounds like a great space. And you guys are fundraising, right, to get a matching grant. Kai, will you tell us a little bit about that?
Absolutely. So the our gracious friends over at the Indianapolis Housing and Community Development Association have a Creating Places initiative to help transform public and accessible spaces, right, in town. So we have a $50,000 matching grant from them.
Wow.
To contribute and match every dollar that we are currently raising in our crowdfunding campaign.
I love it.
To kick off construction here at the beginning of next year.
Where can people who might have a musician in their family, or they might be a musician themselves, where can they get involved? Where do they need to go?
Absolutely. So you can find us at indiemusiccoop.org, Sleepy or Kai, K-A-I, at indiemusiccoop.org if you'd like to reach out to us directly. And then you can find the link to our Patronicity campaign through there.
Man, I'm going to check it out too, just as a fellow artist.
Yeah,
guys, thank you so much for what you're doing in the city and the arts, and thank you for being here today on Indie Now, guys.
Thanks, Brian.
Best of luck.
For having us.
Yeah,
you bet.
Let's
jam sometime.
Man, I'd love that.